My name is Adeline Moore, and today we are turning into the one, the only, Cheryl Blasso. If you guys like this video, make sure to give it a like and also make sure to subscribe. Vlog cam. I typically like to put my hair in braids just because I feel like it lays flatter against my head when I put my wigs on. So we'll do that. Ready? Hey, I have a vlog channel, by the way. You should subscribe. It's fun over there. Okay, back on normal camera.
Okay, I'm liking this. We're already starting to look like Cheryl. By the way, before anyone asks, I got this shirt. I think it's my mom's closet. And this black choker from Forever 21. If you hear jingle jangles in the background, it's Blue walking around. NYX Pore Filler Primer. This is my favorite one from the drugstore. It actually makes your face look so flawless. And I was so excited to do Cheryl because Cheryl is just so glam. She has her red lipstick, she has her lashes, she has her contour. I'm really, really, really excited. And if you guys don't know, I'm actually doing every single one of the Riverdale characters. So I already did Veronica, Archie, and doing Cheryl right now, then I have Betty and Jughead. So the playlist will be down below in case you want to watch them all. You could do like a group Halloween costume or something fun like that. Got the primer and my lipstick swatches because I wasn't sure which shade Cheryl was. I don't know if she's like a dark red or a light red. I don't know. We're gonna figure it out at the end of the tutorial. So I'm just putting the primer on with my fingers just because I feel like the warmth of my fingers melts it into my skin, and it's the first thing you put on your skin, so I feel like it's acceptable. No foundation. I wasn't sure which shade Cheryl was, so I grabbed 5. I'm gonna go with the lightest shade. Shade literally number 1. So we're gonna try and see if it works. And normally I grab a beauty blender, but I'm feeling schnazzy today and I'm gonna use the foundation brush. Also, my dog ate my beauty blender, so that's another reason why I'm not using a beauty blender. This is an opportunity to be one of those artsy Instagram posts. Ready for this? Ooh, 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 ooh! I don't know the Instagram model, watch out! Oh, I forgot to mention, this is the NYX Total Control Drop Foundation. Now, with a little bit of bronzer, we went a little bit light, so this is the NYC bronzer, and I'm sculpting up my face. So I'm gonna be doing the 3E effect, so a 3 on this side, and then an E on this side.
I'm gonna go really lightly though.
I'm contouring my nose so it's similar to hers. She has a very small bridge, but then she has a little button nose, so we're gonna contour the bottoms as well.
And since she has those Kylie Jenner lips though,
we can contour underneath our lips and above as well, because that just gives the illusion of bigger lips.
Blush. Cheryl is so amazing with her red, her lipstick, her red blush. So I'm taking this as the NYX blush in Rose Garden and putting that all over my apples and my cheeks. And then with the translucent powder, I'm just gonna go over top of it all to set it. And my neck as well. I don't want to forget my neck and my ears and look a little weird. My lips are looking a little bit crusty right now, so I'm putting my favorite lip balm on, and it's the Rose Salve lip balm from Bath & Body Works. I love this stuff. It's just fall and foundation. They just don't work well with my lips. Now eyebrows. My eyebrows are far too dark to be Cheryl, so I'm taking a glue stick.
Yes, a glue stick. And just basically erasing my eyebrows. So the way that I do it is I kind of brush back and forth with the glue stick, hoping to get my eyebrows as flat as possible to my face. Alright, I got a couple layers on there. And then with a dry makeup sponge and the transparent powder that we're already using, blue. Did you want to be in the video that bad? Okay, I'm grabbing that with the sponge, and then I'm gonna pat it over top of the brows. I look terrifying. Alright, and then with a big fluffy brush that Blue always eats because you think it's a squirrel or something, I'm gonna take away the excess powder. And then with a light concealer, I'm using literally this white liquid lipstick as a concealer. And I'm gonna mix it with the foundation. You lift my foundation out of my face, I swear, Blue. But there, I don't know if you can see, but there's a bit of a blue undertone to the eyebrows. So I'm gonna take a yellow because it's blue and orange. Yellow's close enough. Blue and orange are complementary colors that cancel each other out. I'm gonna try and cancel out the blue. Alright. Go over it with the foundation and the powder one more time. Powder off. Well, if I learned anything from this tutorial, it's to get rid of your eyebrows before you do your contour and makeup and everything, because I literally had to do everything all over again. But Now I'm using my NYX eyebrow pencil. It's a NYX Precision Brow Pencil in Auburn. And I'm gonna draw my eyebrows similar to Cheryl's. All right, I kind of screwed the NYX pencil and I started using this ColourPop gel eyebrow pomade in Redhead. And then I mixed it with a little bit of concealer to make it a bit lighter, and then I started making strokes in my eyebrows, and I just pretended as if I was making a painting, like every single eyebrow hair. Now I feel like the wig looks so much more realistic on me, because when I have my black eyebrows, they look crazy. And just as a little touch up, I'm getting the blush again and kind of, I know we put it on our cheeks, but I want to kind of even it out. A little bit on our nose, not too much, or else we're going to look a little bit sick. Our chin, a little bit on the forehead. For that kind of rosy glow. Rosie, my editor, turning myself into my editor. Now, highlight. So this just came in the mail. It's a Wet n Wild, it's their new highlighting powder. And I swatched it, wasn't too crazy, and Cheryl's highlight isn't too crazy, so I thought, put the two together on my face. So I'm getting a little bit of the highlight. And again, her highlight isn't crazy, so I'm only putting a little bit on the tops of my cheeks, maybe on the tip of my nose a little bit, on my chin, definitely, my forehead in the middle. Ooh, this just made my face look way more awake and alive. I'm gonna grab a little bit on a flat shader brush and put it on the inner corners of my eyes. Ooh, that's nice. Eyeshadow. I also, this is new, I just got this in the mail. You can watch my unboxing on my vlog channel. I also do unboxings on my Instagram too, so little plug. Follow my social medias at Adeline Warren on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, and Facebook. I'm doing a giveaway.
A plug. You can do.
You know if you want. No, it's just totally up to you. Anyways, I'm grabbing this palette. Can we take a second for all of these colors? I love this orange color right here. So all I did was I grabbed that peanut butter shade on the top and I put that in the crease and underneath my eyes. And then with the transition color on the bottom, I put a little bit more towards the outer part of my eye, like the outer corner. And then that's really it. It's not too crazy with Cheryl's eye look.
I feel like everything's like wrapping up together and the red lipstick is gonna be the cherry on top of the cake.
Now, eyelashes. I did my research. I looked hard into the photos, and I think, with my heart, I think that she uses fake eyelashes, and they're so natural and nice, so I decided to use my favorite ones ever, the Kiss 11 eyelashes with my black duo eyelash glue. Let's do this. The way that I always do my eyelashes is I get my duo black eyelash glue, because black is my favorite, and I just get that on the back of my hand, a little smidge, and then I get the eyelashes, and I kind of drag it through the glue. And that's how I get the perfect line of glue on my eyelashes. And I always tell you guys, say it together, shall we? Let the glue dry. Wait for it to get tacky. It makes applying eyelashes so much easier. Hi, I'm Cheryl Blossom. I'm the captain of the Riverdale Vixens, and I have all of your eyelash tricks for you. Okay, low-key, I look in the mirror and I'm a little bit scared. I'm like, whoa. Sometimes I'm like, whoa, I look like Rosie. And the way that I put on my eyelashes, so they kind of, I put it in the middle first, and then I adjust it on the inside, I adjust it on the inside, and then that's the way the news goes. By the way, I didn't tell you guys, basically, since my last tutorial, this is what happened. I went to one of the Riverdale pop-up shops for Pops, Pops Diner, and I went to get a milkshake, and I literally waited in line for 2 hours for this damn milkshake, but it was worth it. You have to check out my vlog, it'll be in the iCard somewhere. It was so much fun. Now I'm getting my Forever 21 eyelash curler. I'm going to be curling my eyelashes up to the heavens where my brother Jason Blossom rests in peace. And then to kind of make my eyes look similar to hers and have the same shape, I'm just gonna go and line underneath, basically just the outside in a very light line. And I'm just gonna smudge it with my fingers. Guys, I just got a new mascara. Is this not the most satisfying thing? Okay, you ready? What noise did I just make? Oh my god, I love it. So satisfying. But I'm taking my CoverGirl So Lashy mascara and I'm just putting that on basically the roots of my eyelashes just to kind of mix my real ones with the fake ones. Oh my god, I love the little ball at the top. It makes going at the roots of my eyelashes so easy. A tiny bit of mascara on the bottom.
Wait, isn't Riverdale like sponsored by CoverGirl?
I am Cheryl Blossom, I'm senior captain of the Riverdale Vixens, and you should buy CoverGirl mascara. The last thing to do is the signature red lip that Cheryl has. I'm gonna start off with my red lip liner. This one is the Rimmel Exaggerate Full Color Lip Liner in Red Diva. I'm gonna overline my lips because her lips are so amazing and big, and they're her real lips, by the way. I was stalking her YouTube channel and I ran that out. I don't know if I should do this dark red or this light red. So that's the light red, and this is the dark red. Ooh. 20 hours later, I've decided to use the red lip color. This is the Maybelline Superstay Matte Ink Lip Thingy in Pioneer. Guys, this is so crazy. This would be perfect if I could curl my hair, but this wig is like, it's a synthetic wig, so even if I did try to curl it, it wouldn't really curl. But yo, the lipstick made the biggest difference. All I did was overline. This is the Cheryl Blossom makeup tutorial. Either this one or the Veronica one has been my favorite so far. Oh my gosh. If you do this makeup look, make sure to tweet me, because all of you guys have been tweeting me for Veronica makeup looks. But yeah, you guys are amazing. Adelaide is so amazing. And I'm just like, I'm really, really, really happy with how it turned out. Okay, I really don't want to, but in every single Riverdale tutorial, I turn myself into the comic version as well. So farewell, my perfect, beautiful Cheryl Blossom makeup. But don't worry, I took a lot of photos and videos. And a lot of Snapchats, girl, you can add me on Snapchat as well. I'm just Adelaide Morin. We're going from Riverdale to Archie Comics. So I've done a little bit of research on how to do comic book makeup, and I think I can do it a little bit better than how I did my Archie and Veronica one. So we're gonna try and dabble our way through our comic bookness, our comic book artistry. So basically all that you're gonna need is a black eyeliner and a white eyeliner. I got two of each, just in case, because I just got two of each. I'm starting with the black. This is the Too Faced eyeliner. But obviously you can use like any black eyeliner, it works. I'm just gonna outline my face. Cheryl has her winged liner. She's a double wing. Do you see this? Double wing? So I found that a lot of the Archie Comics noses, they're basically all the same. It's just a little line, like a curvy line near the center of your nose, and then a little triangle on the bottom. Betty's, Veronica's, so many characters' noses are like this in the Archie Comics. And then I'm gonna really emphasize my eyelids. I put two little lines above my actual eyelids. And let's figure out, Cheryl's eyebrows are completely black in the comics, but I feel like that won't be as cute. So I'm gonna do kind of like an ombre. I feel like that would be way cuter. So I'm basically making the end part of my eyebrows black. Isn't this way cuter than having a completely black brow? I'm gonna put two little lines underneath, and then I'm gonna make my smile line. They all kind of have this, like a little dimple. Now the white. This is where it's gonna look really 3D. Made a little highlight on my lips. That's on the top lip too. Ooh, that looks cool. I did some of my eyelids and my nose. Just basically highlighting some features of my face. You can even whiten the inner corners of your eye. This makes me have to sneeze. Oh my gosh. This will just give the illusion of bigger, more cartoon-like eyes. And you can even outline the white to give more dimension. Give it more dimension, you know? And we're done with the Cheryl Blossom cartoon look. I think this is my favorite cartoon look that I've done so far. I've definitely improved. Tip of the day is practice makes perfect, because I feel like my first few cartoon videos, they just like weren't really the best. But as I keep making tutorials, I keep learning and I keep getting better. At least I think I'm getting a little bit better. What do you guys think? But now you can just walk around with a sign that says kapow and just be like, like all day long, all Halloween. But yeah, this is my finished Cheryl Blossom makeup tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to give it a thumbs up, and also make sure to go subscribe. And I did all of the Riverdale cast, so make sure to check my playlist down below. I did Archie, Veronica, me, Cheryl, Betty, and Jughead. All for Halloween. I'm also doing a giveaway. You win all of this amazing makeup. November 1st. Now all you basically gotta do is follow me on my social medias. That's really it. Just be active. The most active and dedicated Adelaide Angel wins. Yeah, I hope you guys have a beautiful, magical, wonderful day. Practice makes perfect. Practice your makeup look before you do it on Halloween. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!